Ladies and gentlemen, it's the comedians!
Chi mamma davanti? I go up every Sunday to see, you know, take some soft sweets and that. And she reminisces, you know. Tells us about years ago when six of us used to be in the tin bath. On a Saturday night. And she used to put a brick on the one end. You know, the older you were, the deeper you went. You know, aren't it?
I mean, I haven't been to an AA meeting. Shit, you can't get a drink then. Like that.
Just tell you a little bit about myself. I was born on the 6th, 7th and 8th of September. And it's very hard to believe this, but I was an ugly child. Even my incubator had tinted glass. I was walking when I was 3 months old. There's no bottom in the pram.
I told him that one about the Scouser. He starts on the building site. 10 o'clock in the morning, he's sitting there, not a sandwich. He saw this one, I said, would you like a sandwich, Scouser? He said, I wouldn't mind, Pat. He only started this morning. He said, have one of mine. Scouser visited the sandwich. He said, you don't mind me asking you, Paddy, what's on these sandwiches? He said, crab paste. He said, crab paste? Where'd you buy that? He said, the chemist.
And she told me, my mum, you know, on a Saturday, when he used to go to the messages, give me threepence, you know. She said, we'll have rabbit pies today. Go and get me a rabbit. And try and get one with the ump on its back. To keep the crust up.
I bought a dress once and I'm walking down the shop and I put it on, we went out and he said behind me, have you seen the size of your ass from behind? I said, do I look like a giraffe to you? What are you trying to say? He said, it's the size of a four-ring gas burner on a barbecue a couple of nights later. And he said, you fancy me? I said, I'm not putting the barbecue on for half a sausage. Come on, come on, come on. It's doing me head in now. It's doing things that annoy me, like wake up of the morning. I don't know whether your husband's anything like mine. He's got remote control syndrome. Oh, it's terrible. Sitting in the house. Got the remote control like some Masonic symbol. Kept hidden deep in the bowels of the back of the couch. And you're watching the telly and it pulls it out and starts flicking through the whole system. Flick, 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 flick. And you're like that. Saying to yourself, I didn't know Pat Butcher was in Coronation Street. And all of a sudden you just go, fuck off!
my granddad, he was a smashing fella. And I used to sit in front of him, cross-legged, when I could. I said, "Grandad, tell me stories about the war. Because here's the bloody war, was the Somme." He says, "Son, we used to dig trenches, 2 foot deep. It rained and rained for weeks on end. Sometimes there was 8 foot of water in them. We used to pass messages back and forwards to the front line by the use of carrier pigeon, because there was no phones, mobiles or faxes. And there was a pigeon stranded in no man's land with a broken wing, part of its beak missing. It was soaked to the skin of feathers. A vital message tied to his leg. And the captain turned to my granddad, ladies and gentlemen, the war hero. He turned to him, he said, "Granddad, I didn't know your name. Will you go and get the message off the pigeon?" He said, "I'll go." And he crawled through all the muck and bullets and mortar bombs. He lost an ear and a thumb. And eventually, he got back. And the captain turned to him. He said, "Before I get the medicals here, did you get the message off the pigeon?" He said, "I did." He said, "Thank God for that. What was it?" He went, "Grrr."
A lot of people don't like us because we say what we mean. We don't beat around the bush. With the ale house the other day, this fella turned out to his mate. He said, "You never get 3 days the same in the 1 week here." His mate said, "What do you mean, like?" He said, "Monday gets a telegram from America. Our kid had died and left me an oil well and $1 million. His mate went, "Oh my God." He said, "Tuesday, I get another telegram from Canada. My sister had died, left me a big spread, worth $5 million. His mate went, "Oh my God." He said, "This morning, fuck all." The difference between a Merseyside girl and a terrorist, you can negotiate with a terrorist.